So myself is Pawan Kalan. I am working as assistant professor in St. Martin's Engineering College in the Department of Mechanical Engineering. Today I am going to discuss about a topic called machine tools and metrology. In machine tools we are having different types of machines like lathe machines, drilling machines, as well as shapers, planers, and then we are having milling machines also. Today I am going to give brief introduction about each and every type of machine so that you can able to understand about machine tools. And coming to metrology, in metrology we are dealing with different types of measurement, so that we are going to discuss each and everything clearly briefly in this lecture. So coming to machine tools, we are having three important machines like lathe machines, and then after that we are having drilling machines, and then we are having milling machines, right? Milling machines. So these are the different types of machines which we are using in production technology in order to produce our required component of a particular size as well as dimension. So coming to lathe machines, we are having different types of lathe machines like Indian lathes, nowadays. Right. So nowadays the advanced machines have come into existence, that is automatic lathe machines. Here no involvement of any human there is no need to involve any human source. Okay, so that today we are going to deal with most of our automatic lathe. In coming to drilling machines, we are having different types of drilling machines like sensitive drilling machine, upright drilling machines, all those sort of things. So most commonly used drilling machines in nowadays are sensitive drilling machines, right? So these are the most commonly used drilling machine in each and every production lab. And then one more thing is there, that is radial drilling machines are also most common drilling machines we are using in production technology lab. And then coming to milling machines, in these three types of machine, our main motive is to remove the material, excess material present in the workpiece, in order to get our required shape as well as size. These three machines, lathe machines as well as drilling machines as well as milling machines, these three machines we are using to remove excess material from the workpiece in order to obtain our required shape and size. So why are we going with these three machines, right? So instead of having lathe machine, we are having some advantages over drilling machine, right? And then we are having some more advantages with milling machines. Okay, see, our main motive is to remove excess material, right? Excess material from workpiece to obtain required shape and size, right? Required shape and size. See, this is the main motive of our these three types of machines. Okay, so now this is our main module. Then why we are going with the different types of machines? Okay, here we are having some advantages of machines, so that we are going with milling machine. So now coming to construction details of all these machines. Okay, construction details we are having. Construction details is similar, but we are using different types of cutting tools like single point cutting tool. Discussing about single point cutting tool, it is having two sharp faces, that is principal face as well as side face, side cutting edge. And then we are having another thing is multi point cutting tool. So this multi-point cutting tool where it is milling machines. So multi-point cutting tool is nothing but it is a combination of single point cutting tools. Okay. So this is all about different tools which we are using in lathe machines as well as milling machines. Right? Coming to advantages. See, milling machines occupies milling machines. आपको प्राइस वेरी लेस फ्लोर एरिया कंपेयर टू लेथ मशीन्स एज वेल एज ड्रिलिंग मशीन्स ओके सो एंड देन मटेरियल रिमूवल रेट इज हाई इन मिलिंग And then one more thing is cost effective. And then cost effective. These are the advantages of milling machines over lathe machines as well as drilling machines. So this is a brief introduction about different types of machines and their functions and then advantages and what are the various tools we have used. Okay. So now next thing is. So this is all about today's lecture. Thank you. Manjeshi,
please.
Inga ense bo. Inga. Now I am going to discuss about construction details of milling machines. As we have discussed earlier, milling machine is one of the portable machine and then one of the machine which is going to produce high quality products in less amount of time. So. Now I am going to discuss about various parts which are involved during machining. So coming to first of all, we are having base. Right? See, and then we are having column. And then over column we are having a overhead arm, over arm. And then with After that, we are having an arser, right? Here we are having a spindle. And then with connection to this spindle, we are having an arser. So this is our arser. This is our arser. And this is our motor arm. And then we are having a milling cutter here. The milling cutter is placed here. This one is milling cutter. And then we are having here. We are having knee here. This is knee. And then here having elevating screw. Elevating screw, right? Elevating. And then over the knee we are having a saddle. And then over the saddle we are having a work table, right? So in this work table we are going to fit our workpiece. This is our workpiece which is to be machined. This is our workpiece, and then this is the table, and then this one is the saddle. So these are the different parts of milling machine. So now I am going to discuss about each and every part function. So coming to base, base is made of cast iron, right? So this is made of cast iron because see the main purpose of making base is with the help of cast iron is it will absorb uneven vibrations which are caused during machining. And then this component will hold each and every component of milling machine. And then over base we are having a column on the left side of the base. So in this column we are having driving mechanism. We are having driving mechanism. This driving mechanism is used to give power to the spindle. See, this driving mechanism receives power from the motor and then it will transfer those power to the spindle and makes the spindle to rotate. So and then over the spindle we are having an arbor, right? We are having here arbor. So this arbor, the sole purpose of arbor is used to hold the cutting milling cutter tightly without any disturbances. So after the spindle starts rotating, then with respect to the spindle, armor also starts rotating. So then our milling cutter also starts rotating. So with the help of knee, we are giving motion to the workpiece, which is to be machined, right? So which is to be machined by adjusting the knee as well as table. We are giving feet to the workpiece in order to do our machining in order to obtain our required product. So this is all about construction details of milling machine. So we will continue next class in other details in next class. Thank you.